Everybody, today we're going to be talking about the famed classic of Super Mario Bros. So this is a review video, and we're just going to be talking about how this game is formed, and what it is, and what's the meaning of it. So this game, what it's supposed to be is, it's supposed to be a platform game, which is one player and two player. So, most of the people don't play this game these days because they're kind of obsessed with new consoles because they just don't like the NES. So, these main enemies that you see on the screen here are called Goombas, and they are supposed to be the main bad guys. So, there is the final boss, and the final boss is named Bowser, and he's a giant turtle guy. So, as you can see, you can get power-ups in this game by collecting these things called mystery blocks. So, that right there is a fire flower. If you get it, you can shoot fireballs, which is really insane. But if you get hit, you lose your power-up. Also, there's some jumps that are pretty hard to make. There is secrets, and there's pipes. So, pipes are these little holes, these green little holes like that one you see over there, and you can go inside it, but sometimes you can't go inside it, and sometimes you die like that. And so how come you can't go inside it, you ask? Well, sometimes there's two ways you can't go inside it. One, you just can't go inside it, and two, maybe there's a piranha plant in there that is guarding the way. You can also kill these piranha plants, but you cannot jump on them. So, as you can see, the turtles, those things are called Koopa Troopas. So Koopa Troopas, you can jump on them, and they'll turn into a shell. If you jump on them again, they'll just go flying off their shell, but you can take the shell. And also, how you win is you reach that flag right over there, and the higher you get on the flag, the more points you get, and if you get on the highest point of the flag, you will get a 1-up. So, this level is a new level, and it is a cave level. So, cave levels are necessarily harder than the other levels, because basically it's just the second level, and the second level is always harder than the first level in the gaming. So this level, I'm gonna tell you a little secret here. So you can break down these, you can break down these bricks over here, and you can get on top of that. You can get on top of that little walkway over there, and you can just run for the level like this. So if you get on top of there, you can go through half the level without even trying to face any enemies. So that's just a little cheat they added in there. So this game, like I said, is a Nintendo classic. So this game is very, very popular around Japan or whatever. So, as you can see, we are getting the fire flower over there. There's a fire flower. And also, some bricks are kind of secret, and they give you coins. Coins can help you get 1-ups. If you get 100 coins, you can get a 1-up. And also, there's a bunch of other Super Mario games on different systems. So, one Super Mario game that is on a different system is, all you guys know, is Mario Kart 8. So, there's a bunch of Mario Karts. There's just not Mario Kart 8. And as you can see, there's piranha plants. So, you can go inside. And look, see, there's secrets. So, there is a bunch of Mario Kart games. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, just Mario Kart 8, Mario Kart, just Mario Kart, There's Mario Kart 2, Mario Kart 3, all those. So, Mario was one of the first platforming games there was around. So as you can see, we beat the cave level and we are moving on. So, also, there is these cloud levels where you can go down and you can fall off the platform anytime. See, these are different because there's different enemies. There's also flying Koopas and red Koopas and blue shell Koopas. Blue shell Koopas are the hardest Koopas to defeat, and reds are the second hardest to defeat. Flying Koopas are the third hardest to defeat, and just normal Koopas are the fourth hardest to defeat. Those are really easy to defeat. Okay. So, as you can see, there's a lot of coins in Mario. And also, you can see what worlds you are on and what your time is. And you can run out of time, and once you run out of time, you just get killed automatically, and you have to restart the level. And the number of lives you have, if you miss all your lives, if you get rid of all your lives, you have to start the game all the way back to the first level. So as you can see, there's the flying Koopa right there we've been talking about. And you can jump on it to give yourself a little boost, but it's not that high. So, as you can see, we got a game over, and you're going to have to start again from the menu screen. But it's okay, because these levels are not usually that long, and they're pretty short. So you can speedrun them, like, really hard, and if you just want to take your time, discover all the secrets, you can do that too. I usually just go along with the game, defeating all of them, all of the Koopas and Goombas I see, and just taking it slowly. I don't really speedrun, because if I speedrun, I am likely to die. So, as you can see, we got 3 Mario lives. We're entering the pipe again for the cave level. And as you can see, some Goombas can get on top of each other. And once they get on top of each other, they make a bigger thing. And sometimes you can't even reach them, and you're gonna have to use a shell or something like that. So, what you're supposed to do is you're just supposed to get all through, and the last level of this game is the lava level. That is where Bowser is, and Bowser is one of these easy bosses, as you can see, because Bowser, you're not really supposed to do anything with him. You're just supposed to jump over him, hit this axe, and then he will go down. So we are at the cloud level right when we get in the castle. So your objective is to save Princess Peach from Bowser. And the newest game you might think of, everybody kind of knows this game, is Super Mario Odyssey. Just released on the Nintendo Switch about a month ago. And it is the new hit game on the Switch. And everybody is getting it. And most of them are sold out in stores. So, also, there's some classic Super Mario Bros. That cost like $100 or something. So, yeah. And we are entering the big castle. The big castle means you're on the last level. One of the last levels. As you can see, we're at the lava level over here. So this is one of the last levels. And it is actually really hard for me, Maybe not for some of you guys, but it's just really hard for me. So you just have to stop because there's these flame thingies and they can hit you really easily. And there's a lot of them. Also, there's these fireballs that come out of the lava and try to get you. And there's the lava pistons right over there. See, and this is where you're supposed to defeat Bowser. Well, see, you just jump over him, hit the axe, and bam. Thank you, Mario. Says, oh, so you gotta, see, this is one of the last levels. It's not the last level, like I said. So the princess is still in the other castle. So we got the fire flower. And we are on to the next level, which is our farmland level. This land has a lot of power plants, and also there's these cloud things. I don't know if they show up in this level or another level. Those are the things that pick you up in Mario Kart when you fly off the stage. But those are helpful in Mario Kart. But in this game, they are really not helpful because they drop little spike troopers out of the sky that you cannot jump on them. And as you can see, we just reached a secret over here. We just reached the vine. And once you get on the vine, this is the level with the cloud guy. So you might see that there's clouds of smiley faces on the ground. And you are traveling on a platform that is made out of popcorn. So when you have reached the end, you go up. And that is not the level. I think there is some cloud guys in the other levels. I don't think there is in this level. And as you can see, that's a bounce pad. So if you hold down the jump button, you can go really high on the bounce pad, but you're not supposed to jam it. And we reached the next level. As you can see, we're in the normal castle, so we know it's not the last level. So we have 4 lives because we just got a 1-up from our 100 coins. And now there's the water level. These have ink cloud things. I don't think you can jump on them. Actually, yes, you can. And there's coral in this level. And once you throw the fireballs, they go faster than they usually do on land. And they are not usually supposed to be in the water levels, but I guess you can have them for water levels. So here is the fish. In normal games, you might know that they are green, but in this level, they are gray. And there is a red fish. Gray and red fish. So these fish are supposed to be really, really easy to defeat, because they just swim along really slowly in one little place. So they move really slow, so that's what makes them pretty easy to kill. And there's another one, and another one, and another one. There's a lot of fish in this level. So you just gotta kill them all to reach the next level. This is just basically the level with a lot of fish in it. That's what I like to call it. And as you can see, there's a secret up there. Okay, I first thought that was a secret, but no. And also, I am not the one playing this game. I am just reviewing it. Okay, so sometimes if you reach the bottom of the water, you can drown if there's no platform under it. and see when you get to less than 100 times, the music starts to go faster and the time starts to go faster. But we reach the end of the level just on time. Okay. So we are on level 2-3. This is the one with the flying fish. Okay. So it's kind of weird because this is supposed to be a land level and there's fish in it. But those are just jumping out of the sea. And as you can see, we already have fire power up. So sometimes, and they just give you, if you have a duplicate of the other power-up, they just give you some extra points. But in Super Mario Land or Super Mario World, Super Mario 3D Land, you can keep those power-ups, you can save those power-ups, and you can use them in other levels. So we are in the next lava level, it looks like. This might be the end. But we never know. See? And we just died. But luckily we have 4 lives, so it doesn't really matter. So as you can see, we're small again, and we only have 1 life. See, if you get mushrooms, you get bigger, and you have 2 lives. So you can get hit 2 times, and then you die. But if you get hit 1 time while you're small, you instantly die. So there's these pearl things over here that are very hard, I think. See, so there's a lot of stuff coming at you in this level. That's what makes it so challenging. So you can hide under these holes to get away from the fire pistons. And we are on the Bowser. Okay, so Bowser is the one shooting the fireballs, not the fire pistons. So, you just gotta get that axe, because if you hold down the jump bucket button, you can probably get down over on those bricks, as you can see. Ooh. Okay, and we got Bowser. And there's Toad, but we know the princess is in the other castle, but that is going to be it for this review video. And we will do the other castle later in the other episode. So like, subscribe, comment on this video. Say it's good, say it's bad, I don't care. It's just, yeah. Just do the thing that